Hello, every YouTube buddy. We are just about ready to begin the final quest. I talked to Daniel once, and I was able to make the final decision on whether to help him evacuate Zion or to help Joshua stay and fight. And I told him I needed some time to think about it because I wanted to find out if there's anything else, like any other side quests that I might be interested in before we go on the main quest, or the final quest. And it turns out there is one. Waking Cloud has one. So watch this. I talked to her, and I've seen this dialogue option before. Do you have any family? Let's talk about it.
A fine husband and three children. I miss them each day, but I take comfort in knowing they are safe.
Safe.
When we learned that Salt Upon Wounds had defiled Zion with his presence, Daniel ordered the children, the old, and the sick evacuated from the camp.
Yeah.
My husband volunteered to lead the hunters that went with them for protection.
I see.
I try not to worry about them, but we have had no news for so long, and Daniel seems sad when I ask him
about it. I wonder why.
Sad and...
a little frightened.
A little frightened.
Okay, I could talk to him. Maybe he'll open up more.
Perhaps he will. I sometimes feel he thinks he must protect me. If he has news, I would know of it.
Maybe not. Okay, so we're going to, see.
Then I will look forward to our next...
speaking. And we now have a new quest called Family Affairs. So let's go back to Daniel and talk to him about her husband and children who were evacuated earlier. See, so he's already partially evacuated Zion. The old and the children have gone. And that's why you don't see any children around Zion. There, now he's over here again. It's not too hard. Ah, he's gone. Damn him. Just when I need him, he goes away. I think I could find him. Well, that's where he sleeps, but I could probably find him at the place where I first met him. Let's go over there. See, over to Sour's camp. No, forget it. We're not going to Sour's camp. I've got the blip right on my radar, and now he's down there on that ledge. So we need to figure out a way to get down there. I think I can just kind of, this ledge is so steep, I can't traipse alongside it. We found a cave. By the way, there are many caves. There's like an entire cave system that kind of gains you access to all these other terraces throughout the slot canyons. And that's how you kind of get up and around. There. Okay, there. Now we're okay. We can drop down here. And where the hell's Daniel? Oh, he likes to watch the waterfall in the morning. All right, Daniel.
Unless you and Joshua have any objections, I'd like to start evacuating the Sawyers.
Nope, not yet.
I'm going to need your help, so say your piece.
Uh-huh. No, I don't want to make up my mind yet about that. Tell me about Waking Cloud's family.
What do you want to know, exactly? I'm sure she could tell you much better than
I. Yeah, sure she could. She said, did you help the rest of her family leave Zion?
I did.
What's the matter?
Her three children are safe. They made it north weeks ago and met up with new Canaanites heading east.
Uh-huh.
Her husband didn't make it. He died protecting their children from a white leg attack.
Well, I see.
Do not tell Waking Cloud. She is one of the only sorrows who can communicate easily with us, and her tribe needs her to be strong right now.
Guess what I'm going to do?
To everything, there is a season. Who are you or I to put this heavy burden on her now?
I am the truth. And you are a schmuck. Supposed to help lead these people, not hide things from them, yes.
I know, you're right. I shouldn't have hidden it from her in the first place. I just...
Mm-hmm. We can't fail here again.
Zion can't become the next New Canaan. The Sorrows don't deserve that.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes I look at them and wonder if they would have been better off if those old trails had stayed forgotten.
Maybe.
If we had never found any of them. Tell Waking Cloud if you think that's best.
Okay, I'm gonna do it. And I'm not ready to make my decision either yet. So now, let's just walk back over here and we should be able to intercept her again. And then we'll tell her that her husband died and that Daniel was keeping it from her. Come on, Waking Cloud, where are you? Over here. Would you come over here? I'm just gonna wait here, and as soon as she reaches, oh, there she is.
Took New Canaan. He ordered the white.
Shop. All right.
Katubiu.
Katubiu. There, I'm afraid he was killed.
What? No. You must be mistaken. Daniel would have told me.
Oh, grow up, lady. I'm afraid so. Yeah, he thought the grief would distract you.
How dare he? What gives him the right? I thought Daniel was my friend. But
yes,
he cares nothing for the sorrow.
Yes, he does, lady. He was only doing what he thought was best for the tribe.
Perhaps. I will have to have a very long talk with Daniel when all of this is over.
Yeah, well,
thank
that's what you need.
Thank you for telling me this truth.
Sometimes you need long talks with people who don't divulge every detail about life and death. There, so we finished that side quest. And there's one other side quest I'm interested in. Guess who has one more quest for me? It's Follows Chalk. So we're going to go over and find him in a second. Let me pause first.
Okay, so we just need to find... what's his name? And I think he's going to be over here. So we do... yeah, we have to go to Angel Cave. And... Angel Cave. And there he is. Let's talk to Follows Chalk.
What can I tell you?
Yeah, right here. What's with this obsession you seem to have with civilization?
Let me tell you a story.
Mm-hmm.
When I was a boy, a man came through the valley with one of the caravans. Tall man, big mustache.
Carried a guitar.
I asked what he did for his living, and the interpreter told me he was a singer.
A singer.
What is that? I asked. The man explained that he went from place to place and sang for people, who gave him food and shelter and care in return.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't believe that there was a place in this world where a man could do that.
Yeah, there's a place in the world where you can do
then,
just about anything
day,
you can imagine.
I'd explore that world myself.
Uh-huh. What does Joshua think of this?
I haven't told him yet. Never had the Growans.
Mm-hmm. Maybe I could talk to him about it.
You'd do that? Sure. Sounds smart to me.
Okay. And we'll do that. There's also... yeah, see, that starts another quest. Civilized Man's Burden. Tell me a little about the area.
Mostly it's the mountain bighorners.
Mm-hmm.
Whole herd of them up on the cliffs there. Usually they're not too aggressive, but lately... whew. My guess is one of the calves got lost somewhere along the way.
I see.
Bighorners are communal. One missing calf, and the whole herd gets ornery.
Yes.
If that calf doesn't turn up soon, they might very well come down into the valley and attack the camp.
Well, there's... yeah, so I could find... No, let's not do it. Do it. It just seems
too
much work.
That's just what the hunter said. Well, I...
good, so I can always decide to take him up on that later. So let's find Joshua, who happens to be probably way over on the other side of the canyon. Joshua is way over here. Let's make sure that that's what we're looking at. Yeah, tell Dan no. Civilized Man's Burden, there. But yes, Joshua is, like, way over there. What the hell is he doing over there? Talk to Joshua Graham. So we're going right back where we were a minute ago, which is, Whitebird's Cave. And it should be like noon by the time we get over there. And... back at Whitebird's Cave. And let's find Joshua. He's this way. He might be up on a ledge somewhere. Oh, how much do you want to bet that he's like way up where I can't reach him? No, he's back at... okay, now he's over at Sorrow's camp. And... bling! There. That was easy. And there's Joshua.
Welcome back. What can I do for you?
Fowlestruck seems like he's interested in seeing more of the world.
I thought he might. It's been some time since I visited civilized places. I don't have fond memories of them. But I have always seen these places from the outside. I'd rather not influence him more than I already do. Why don't you talk to him?
Talk to him about what? You know, that means I'm going to encourage him to leave, right?
Fowlestruck needs more guidance in his life. Just not from me.
I see. So maybe I have to convince him to stay. I think I can choose. Yeah, that's how it's going to work. So we're not going to do it in this video, but we'll go back to Fowlestruck and we'll decide what to do with him in the next video. So, yeah, let's just end here. If you like this video, then click the like button. That helps me out a lot. And share it with your friends. And you can comment on it and add it to your favorites. You can subscribe to my channel, and then you get those in your inbox. And all that really helps me out a lot. And I greatly appreciate it. And I thank you for doing that. Okay, we'll see you next time. And we'll go back to Fowlestruck.